Did you know that some prehistoric fish had teeth larger than a T-Rex? In fact, the Rhizodus hibberti, a freshwater predator from 350 million years ago, had fangs up to 22 centimeters or 8 to 9 inches long. But these ancient aquatic monsters were more than just big teeth. They possessed unique hunting strategies and anatomical adaptations that made them formidable predators in their time. These creatures played a crucial role in shaping the course of evolution in Earth's waters, leaving a lasting impact on aquatic ecosystems that we can still observe today. The Carboniferous period, roughly 359 to 299 million years ago, was a time of extremes that created an alien world compared to our familiar modern landscapes. The atmosphere contained up to 35% oxygen, significantly higher than today's 21%. This supercharged air fueled the growth of vast swampy forests filled with giant club mosses, horsetails, and ferns, eventually forming the extensive coal deposits that give this period its name. In this prehistoric greenhouse, life grew to proportions that seem impossible by today's standards. The extra oxygen allowed insects to reach massive sizes as they rely on diffusion for oxygen intake. The warm, humid climate and oxygen-rich air created perfect conditions for the evolution of massive aquatic predators. The abundance of diverse flora and fauna provided ample food sources, supporting complex predator-prey interactions and allowing for larger body sizes in the water as well as on the land. Beneath the surface of Carboniferous rivers and swamps, formidable creatures lurked. Baramida, a predatory fish, could reach lengths of 3 to 4 meters or 9 to 13 feet, showcasing the incredible adaptations that the period's unique conditions allowed. However, even Baramida was dwarfed by the true apex predator of these ancient waters, the Rhizodus hibberti. Rhizodus hibberti was a highly specialized killing machine, honed by millions of years of evolution in this alien world. Its massive size and unique features made it the undisputed king of Carboniferous waters, capable of preying on large aquatic creatures and possibly even animals venturing too close to the water's edge. But to truly appreciate why Rhizodus was so terrifying, we need to examine its anatomy closely. The secrets to its success as an apex predator lie in the details of its body structure, each feature a testament to the extreme conditions of the Carboniferous period that shaped it. Modern aquatic predators can't match the ancient terror of Rhizodus hibberti, a Carboniferous giant with formidable biological adaptations. This prehistoric fish was the ultimate aquatic killing machine, capable of dispatching creatures twice its size. But what made Rhizodus so fearsome? At up to 6 to 7 meters long or 19 to 23 feet, Rhizodus dwarfed even the great white shark. Its streamlined body, covered in thick armored scales, allowed for efficient movement through water while providing protection from threats. The powerful pectoral fins and shoulder girdle enabled sudden, explosive movements perfect for ambushing prey in ancient rivers and swamps. Rhizodus possessed sensory adaptations similar to modern crocodiles, making it well suited for hunting in murky waters. Large plate-like armor on its head housed sensory pores, allowing it to detect minute vibrations and pressure changes in the water. This gave Rhizodus an almost supernatural ability to locate prey even in low visibility conditions. The most terrifying feature of Rhizodus was its enormous fangs, which could reach up to 22 centimeters or 8 to 9 inches in length. And these weren't just for show, they were perfectly adapted for grabbing and holding onto large prey, including other fish and even early amphibians venturing too close to the water's edge. Coprolite evidence, or better known as fossilized feces, confirms that Rhizodus fed on smaller fish and amphibians, cementing its position as an apex predator in its ecosystem. This prehistoric powerhouse was capable of taking on a wide variety of prey thanks to its unique combination of size, strength, and sensory adaptations. But Rhizodus was more than just a big fish. It was a highly skilled predator with a hunting strategy honed by millions of years of evolution. Its array of adaptations made it the perfect aquatic ambush predator, ready to strike from the murky depths of Carboniferous waters. You might think you know what makes a perfect aquatic predator, but Rhizodus takes that concept to extremes. This ancient monster turned rivers and swamps into its personal hunting grounds, preying on both aquatic and terrestrial creatures. The Carboniferous period's murky, oxygen-rich waters provided the ideal hunting ground for this massive predator. With its streamlined body and powerful fins, Rhizodus navigated these environments with ease, lying in wait for unsuspecting prey. Rhizodus' hunting strategies likely resembled those of modern crocodiles and large catfish. It probably lurked near the water's edge, using its sensitive lateral line to detect vibrations from animals approaching to drink. When prey was within range, Rhizodus could launch itself from the water with incredible speed, using its powerful jaws and massive fangs to seize its victim. Once Rhizodus had its prey in its grasp, its 22-centimeter or 8-to-9-inch fangs came into play. These enormous teeth were perfectly adapted for grabbing and holding onto large prey. Rhizodus could have used its powerful jaws to tear chunks from its victims, similar to how modern crocodiles dismember their prey. Fossil evidence suggests that Rhizodus had a varied diet, including other large fish that shared its aquatic habitat. However, the most intriguing aspect of Rhizodus' hunting behavior was its ability to prey on early tetrapods, the first vertebrates to venture onto land. Paleontologists believe that Rhizodus was capable of lunging at terrestrial animals that approached the water's edge. This hunting strategy would have had significant implications for the evolution of early tetrapods. Every trip to the water's edge for these emerging land-dwelling creatures could have been their last. The ability of Rhizodus to prey on both aquatic and terrestrial animals made it a formidable force in its ecosystem. Its hunting prowess likely shaped the evolutionary trajectory of many species, influencing the development of defensive adaptations in its prey. The Carboniferous period was a time of evolutionary arms races, with numerous formidable creatures competing for dominance in aquatic ecosystems. How did Rhizodus maintain its position at the top of the food chain, and what other nightmarish predators lurked beneath the surface? The Carboniferous period was an underwater battlefield teeming with nightmarish creatures. While Rhizodus was a formidable apex predator, it shared its waters with a host of other impressive beings, each evolving to carve out its own niche in this competitive ecosystem. One of Rhizodus' most impressive rivals was Baramida decipiens, a giant rhizodont lobe-fin fish reaching lengths of 3 to 4 meters. Covered in thick bony plates for armor, Baramida possessed a powerful bite force capable of crushing bone. The competition between Rhizodus and Baramida likely led to a division of territory, with Rhizodus dominating deeper waters while Baramida ruled the shallows. These two weren't the only players in this aquatic arms race. The Carboniferous waters were also home to other large predatory fish, like Hyneria lindae and various species of placoderms. Each of these creatures had unique adaptations, contributing to the rich biodiversity of the period. The presence of multiple large predators in one ecosystem raises questions about their coexistence. The answer likely lies in the abundant prey species supported by the oxygen-rich atmosphere and lush vegetation of the Carboniferous. This wealth of resources allowed for the evolution of diverse apex predators, each filling a slightly different ecological role. Rhizodus maintained its position at the top of the food chain with its massive size and 22-centimeter or 8-to-9-inch fangs. Its sensory adaptations for hunting in murky waters gave it an edge over many competitors. The ecological role of apex predators like Rhizodus and Baramida was crucial for maintaining ecosystem balance, regulating populations, and promoting biodiversity. The Carboniferous waters were an ecosystem where creatures of various shapes and sizes competed for dominance. In this crucible of evolution, some of the most fascinating species in Earth's history emerged. The legacy of these ancient predators can still be seen in the adaptations of modern aquatic species, demonstrating the enduring impact of this remarkable period. As the Carboniferous period drew to a close, changes were on the horizon that would challenge even Rhizodus' reign. The shifting environmental conditions would test the limits of adaptation for all these prehistoric monsters, setting the stage for the next chapter in Earth's evolutionary history. Imagine a world where Rhizodus still ruled the rivers. Now blink and it's gone. The end of the Carboniferous period, around 299 million years ago, brought a shocking surprise that would spell doom for these ancient river monsters. The world was changing, rapidly. The lush swamps and forests that had characterized the Carboniferous began to recede. Climate patterns shifted, leading to cooler and drier conditions. These environmental changes had a cascading effect on aquatic ecosystems, disrupting the delicate balance that had allowed Rhizodus and its relatives to thrive for so long. As the landscape transformed, so did the composition of freshwater habitats. The once murky waters that provided perfect hunting grounds for ambush predators like Rhizodus became clearer and less hospitable. Food chains were disrupted, with many prey species struggling to adapt to the new conditions. For Rhizodus, this meant a shrinking menu and increased competition for resources. The massive size of Rhizodus, which had made it an unrivaled hunter, now required more energy to sustain in an ecosystem with dwindling resources. Its highly specialized hunting strategies, perfectly suited for the Carboniferous swamps, became less effective in the changing waterways. These factors made Rhizodus particularly vulnerable to the rapid environmental changes occurring around them. As Rhizodus and other rhizodonts struggled, new opportunities arose for other species. Smaller, more adaptable fish began to fill the ecological niches left vacant by the declining giants. These newcomers were better equipped to handle the changing conditions, with more generalized feeding strategies and lower energy requirements. The extinction of rhizodonts marked a significant turning point in the evolution of aquatic ecosystems. As these ancient river monsters vanished, they paved the way for the rise of new predatory fish that would dominate freshwater environments in the following periods. This transition reshaped aquatic food webs and set the stage for the diverse range of fish species we see in modern rivers and lakes. The legacy of these ancient river monsters, however, lives on, hidden in the rocks beneath our feet. The discovery of Rhizodus has completely transformed our understanding of prehistoric life. Imagine a creature so massive and powerful that it dwarfs modern river predators. Reconstructing this ancient beast presents an enormous challenge for paleontologists, akin to assembling a colossal jigsaw puzzle with most pieces missing. The story of Rhizodus began in 1840, when Richard Owen first described a specimen of Rhizodus hibberti. Since then, paleontologists have unearthed fossils across the globe, slowly piecing together the nature of this Carboniferous monster. However, studying Rhizodus is far from straightforward. The sheer size of these creatures means complete specimens are incredibly rare, with most discoveries consisting of isolated teeth or scales. Despite these obstacles, scientists have made significant strides in understanding Rhizodus. Modern paleontological techniques have revolutionized the field. CT scanning allows researchers to examine internal structures without damaging fossils, while isotope analysis provides insights into the creature's diet and habitat. These methods paint a clearer picture of Rhizodus' role in Carboniferous ecosystems. Recent excavations have yielded exciting new specimens that are reshaping our understanding of Rhizodus and its relatives. In Pennsylvania and Australia, paleontologists have uncovered fossils of rhizodontids like Sauropterus tayloriae, providing crucial context for understanding the evolutionary history of these massive predators. Paleontologists studying Rhizodus are clearly excited. Each new discovery has the potential to rewrite what we know about the evolution of vertebrates. The unique adaptations of Rhizodus offer invaluable insights into how life responds to environmental pressures over millions of years. As we continue to unearth these ancient monsters, we're gaining a deeper understanding of evolutionary patterns that shape life on Earth. The story of Rhizodus serves as a powerful reminder of the incredible diversity of life that has existed on our planet and the complex processes that drive adaptation and change over time. But the most fascinating aspect of Rhizodus is what it reveals about our own world. The legacy of Rhizodus extends far beyond its prehistoric dominance, offering intriguing insights into our modern aquatic ecosystems. While this ancient predator no longer patrols our waterways, its ecological role has been filled by a diverse array of modern species. For example, the saltwater crocodile, a creature that uses hunting strategies very similar to those of its ancient counterpart. Like Rhizodus, these massive reptiles are ambush predators, lying in wait at the water's edge for unsuspecting prey. These modern-day giants showcase how evolutionary adaptations honed over millions of years continue to prove effective in today's rivers and oceans. Studying prehistoric predators like Rhizodus provides valuable information that can inform current conservation efforts. By understanding the ecological roles these ancient creatures played, we gain a deeper appreciation for the importance of apex predators in maintaining healthy aquatic ecosystems. This knowledge can guide efforts to protect and preserve modern species that fulfill similar functions in our rivers and seas. The story of Rhizodus prompts us to consider the potential for further evolution in our aquatic environments. With changing climate conditions and human impacts on ecosystems, we may be setting the stage for new adaptations and developments among aquatic predators. The rise and fall of Rhizodus demonstrates the remarkable adaptability of life, suggesting that the future of aquatic ecosystems may hold surprising developments. Understanding Rhizodus and its place in prehistoric ecosystems enhances our appreciation for the complexity and diversity of modern aquatic life. It reminds us that the creatures we see in our rivers and oceans today are the result of millions of years of evolutionary pressure and adaptation. By protecting these modern descendants of ancient predators, we preserve not just individual species, but the intricate web of life that has been millions of years in the making. When we look at our own rivers and oceans today, we're left with a sense of wonder and curiosity. What creatures might be evolving in our waters right now, unseen and unknown? Let me know your thoughts in the comments, and give this video a like if you liked it. If you want to learn more about prehistoric topics, check out this video. Thanks for watching, and until next time.